Hey everybody, I'm Nick Meister and welcome back to Let's Play Hitman Blood Money. Today's a new stage.
It's over, 47. I'm closing shop at this end. This will be your last assignment. There are two targets. Varna Ketlin, a former Romanian circus performer who's now a big player in the global grey market, and a CIA operative who's been playing both sides of the fence. Ketlin's hosting a masquerade party at the Shark Club in Vegas, and the CIA op will be there to close a deal. Even if this job isn't a setup, your presence will almost definitely be expected. You're our only surviving agent, 47. Find out whoever it is that's been coming after us. Eliminate both targets, and anyone that targets you, and exit in the vehicle I'll have ready for you in the parking garage. You've been a very effective agent. It's been pleasant to work with you. I hope the future is kind to you.
Oh man, I'm getting so emotional. I'm pretty sure this is our last mission with Diana. Let's get some new upgrades. Oh, okay, this bulletproof vest will work even though we change outfits. So that's pretty good. And I don't think we'll need anything else, so... Or maybe we'll get binoculars, why not? You know, I don't really ever use them, but what's the point of having money if you don't spend it, right? Well, still in Vegas.
So that's the deal. The dirty CIA agent will be there to drop the high-tech weapons on the host. Eliminate both of them.
Anything else?
It'll probably be crawling with other enemy operatives.
Have you identified them?
They're paid by the franchise.
The franchise? That's Parcesi's group. What's their business here tonight?
I think you are. You and I are all that's left of the Agency 47, and I doubt I'll survive much longer.
I'm sorry to hear that. Has my fee been transferred?
More than usual. I'm splitting what's left of the Agency's resources with you. Good luck, 47. It's been quite a ride.
Good luck yourself.
Wow, that sure was a touching moment between 47 and Diana, wasn't it? Not as touching as an absolution, though, when suddenly he falls in love with her or something, but whatever. I was still in Vegas. You can see there in the distance, but the sun's coming up. You know, this club must be open 24 hours a day or something, because it's got to be like 4 or 5 o'clock in the morning at this point, and, well, things are still hopping in the club. So, let's take a look in here. You know, I think the direct approach is a little too direct. Let's go over here by the side and see if we can sneak in. Alright. And that guy didn't see us at all. Apparently he's got no peripheral vision at all. And you know, that's the thing about stealth games is you're never quite sure how good a person's peripheral vision is. Sometimes NPCs are almost omniscient, and other times they have complete tunnel vision. So, I'm gonna head down here, and I'm gonna try to take this guy's outfit. You know, fuck it, let's just shoot him in the head. Oh, shit, I got glass there. Oh, but it doesn't seem like anyone noticed. Uh-oh. I guess that guy saw the body? Oh, shit, he's calling his friends. Uh-oh. As you can see, my bulletproof vest is absorbing a lot of the damage, so let's try that over again. Only this time, we're not going to be so camera shy. Why not? I mean, we'll just get the tape later anyway, right? Hello? My good man?
I left my briefcase here this afternoon. I was told it'll be held in the staff room there. Could I have it, please?
No one told me about any briefcase.
Are you saying it's been stolen?
Hold on, I'll check.
This guy is a guy who loves his job, huh? So let's follow him into the break room. Very sneakily. And take his life. And his outfit. That's what we need. There we go. Lay him down nice and easy. So the way I'm going to do this is, I guess, the easiest way to get into the garage. but it slows you down a little bit because you have to get the videotape. So let's do that now. Let's go and get the videotape. Okay. Alright, and the security room is right in here. Very convenient for us. And, we want to make sure this guy turns around first. It's kind of tricky getting this tape. And, okay, let's take it. Oh, shit.
This is so boring.
Ow! Fuck you, man. Damn. Of course they just know it's me, right? Okay. Do-over time, do-over. Let's go back in here again. Close the door. And he's not as suspicious this time, so we're able to take the tape without much problem at all. And, Oh, the nurse, huh? Ugh, looks bloody. And based on a true story? Ugh, what kind of story is that? And here's some smiling Asian lady. That woman's face looks sort of familiar. I don't know why. And get a career in games or die trying. Starring 50 Cent. Hey buddy, how's it going? Okay. So let's head down here. Now that we're in our security guard uniform, we can walk around the garage without getting harassed, having hands stuck in our face. But we need to go upstairs. We need to go downstairs. And we can't get past these guys. I don't think.
Hey, buddy, this area is restricted. Get lost.
Okay, how rude. That's the rudest cherub I've ever seen. So what we want to do is we want to get past them, obviously. One way to do it is dress up as a party goer, but problem with that is you need to hide your weapon somehow, or else they'll discover them when they search you. So this time, instead of shooting this guy, we're just gonna put him out nice and easy, put him asleep, and do I hide the body? I don't remember. I recorded this a little while ago. Okay, so I'm dragging the body over to the dumpster here, and hopefully the security guard on our left won't see us as we dump his limp body into this trash. There we go. Have a nice tetanus or whatever. So let's pick this lock here, and okay, nice. So danger falling elevator shaft. Yep. So we're gonna head up here. This first elevator is gonna take us straight to heaven. I'll hop down here. Okay, and now we're gonna hop back up on top of the elevator because, of course, you know, the police, or security guards, I guess, I don't know. We're just not cool enough to be in this club. You know, there's a very specific dress code at these clubs. As you'll soon see, they're very cool, by the way. So, I'm gonna take the scenic route. And I'm gonna hop over here. You gotta be very patient when you're sneaking into the club this way, because, it's very easy to get spotted. These two guys here. There's a guy here who makes his rounds, and there's a guy, I think, over here that's gonna walk through. That guy over there, the guy by the door, I don't know, fuck it, where was I going with that? Nah, doesn't really matter. Anyway, this is a little bit of a waiting game, you know, stealth games, Hitman, sometimes it's just about waiting. So, now that guy's looking through the door for some reason, I don't know why, I'm not gonna question it, and as he's looking through that door, we're gonna shuffle along this this balcony here. I don't know how many times I had to experiment to see what the timing was for me to sneak past here. And oh my. What's that heavenly voice I hear? Oh my. my god, that singing voice is amazing. I just have to find out who that is. Wow, that really is an impressive set of pipes there. Okay, I think there's a guard coming down the hallway, but fuck it. I just have to find out who that singer is, so I'm gonna rush ahead and hopefully I won't get spotted. Put on this guy's outfit. And I'm gonna drag him over here. He was asleep, by the way. He was just sitting here sleeping in the chair. I don't think breaks are made for that, buddy. I think breaks are made for, you know, eating your 7-Eleven dinner and then getting back to work. You lazy bum. Alright. Wow. Oh my god. She is a vision, isn't she? Huh. I wonder who that is. I gotta ask.
Enjoying the party so far, sir?
I gotta ask around.
So far.
Some pretty amazing babes, huh?
Yeah.
You catch a singer? Damn, is she hot. Terrible singer.
What?
I hadn't noticed.
Oh yeah, I had a great singer lined up, but she had a fatal accident yesterday, and they needed a real quick replacement.
Go figure.
This babe can't sing for diddly, and she goes running off for a break in a private room every 5 minutes, but who cares? Eye candy like that? You take what you can get.
I'll keep that in mind.
Having a good time, sir?
I suppose so.
I'm a chef.
How about you?
I belong
Tell
here.
You the truth, I'm dying for a chance at that hottie singing. First break I get, I'm heading straight to that room over there where she hangs out between sets.
Yeah, right, douchebag. You couldn't get laid with someone like that. It's interesting, even though you're dressed as a chef, people still react to you as if you're a party guest. Small oversight, but yeah, so... What am I doing here? I don't remember. Okay, so... Let's, You know, as beautiful as this woman is, and as amazing as a singer as she is, there's just something not right about her. I'm gonna follow her, see where she goes, see what this private room business is all about.
Okay. I hope you're enjoying yourself.
I'm a chef, I belong here, not a party guest. Alright, I don't want this lady to see us. You know, if she sees us, I'm afraid she might be taken in by 47's, handsome visage and I don't know. We won't be able to sneak up on her if she sees us. That's what I'm getting at. So, I'm waiting for her. Okay. I'm gonna head in here and...
Get out of here.
What? Kind of in the middle of something here, buddy. I mean, just because you can't get laid, it doesn't mean that you have to ruin it for me, douche. I'm gonna go in there anyway. And, oh, it doesn't look like they saw us, and, oh, she's on the phone.
Haven't spotted him yet. I'll contact you when he's taken care of. Oh, one more thing. The singing's gonna cost you extra, big time.
Huh. So, it seems like she was actually the assassin all along. Who would have thunk it? You know... I really don't have very much luck wow, it's quite an outfit. It's quite an outfit there. Anyway, I wonder where she was keeping that phone. Ugh. I don't want to think about that. Oh. Huh. So, that yellow gentleman was one of our targets. That conversation with that lady means that he's heading down to hell now. But that's okay, we'll catch up with him later. Let's see what's in this case, by the way. Wow, hey, a dragon off. We haven't seen one of these things since the, Death of a Showman level at the very beginning of the game. It's too bad we can't use it. And here's the laptop with our information on it. Let's get that. There's a picture of an FN 2000, a silver baller, and a syringe. I don't know, I think have I ever used the FN before this game? I'm not sure. Well, that's okay. Alright. What to do. So, now that the CIA agent, the guy dressed in the golden suit, has left, he's down in hell, there's really only one place to go, and that's hell. Let's take a quick look here before we leave. It really is a very cool level, very impressive. Yeah. You know, I do my best to show off every stage and all the things that are in the level, but, you know, that's really hard, you know? When you're playing the game, it's just really hard showing off everything. I encourage you all to get this game on Steam, or maybe an old copy for Xbox 360, I guess? I don't know. It really is a wonderful game. On a side note, I have picked up Absolution since it was half off on Steam. Oh, chefs aren't allowed down in the garage, I don't think. Or maybe they are, I don't know. But, first things first. Wow, it's quite a drop. It wouldn't have been such a big drop if we'd beaten the CIA agent down here in the first place, but, well, what can you do? There we go. Oh, do they care that we're down here? No, they don't. They look a bit nonplussed, though. Nonplussed. They are definitely nonplussed. But, you know, I realized something. We need another outfit. I don't think... Oh, what am I doing here? I can't quite remember. Huh. You know, these guys are gonna search us. So, what I did was I stopped the recording and I dropped my silver baller down the elevator shaft and... Okay. Now we're gonna take care of this guy, put him out of his goddamn misery, because honestly, his puking's grossing me out. There we go. He's dead. Now we're gonna dress up as... Let's make sure that guy's not looking. Okay, good. We're gonna dress up as a guest for hell, or whatever. Okay, drag his body over here. By the way, there is another entrance down to the basement on my left. If you haven't taken the videotape yet, doesn't that look funny? I don't know, there's something about this outfit I really enjoy. So, let's head over here. And, they're gonna search us, but
have to search you, sir.
They're not gonna find anything because, I don't have anything to find. There we go.
Thanks. You're all set.
That guy's voice is funny. He doesn't sound like a tough guy at all. Oh, boy. Nice watch, by the way. Where'd you pick it up? Chinatown? I mean, Oh, fuck it. Alright, so... They're looking at that case. What is in the case, I wonder? I don't know. Probably some really cool weapon, right? Maybe a cool weapon we've never seen before? I don't know. Alright, so here we are in hell, and in my opinion, hell is much more interesting than heaven is. Wow. Creepy ghost faces all over the place. How do they do that? That's amazing, that really is. So I guess heaven's kind of a laid-back lounge for adults in their mid-30s and early 40s, and hell is more of a make-out rave club, as you can see. And for some reason, there's no music. It's kind of weird. The music is on, I'm pretty sure. I gotta say, the dancing in this level as well. It's quite a zoom. Oh, the dancing in this level really is something, huh? Yep. No music, but they're just dancing their asses off. They got a nice, lady-to-gentleman ratio, too. Huh. Alright. So, it looks like our target's there in that room. Oh, and there's another target on our left. I'm not sure what that's all about. Huh. This guy at the bar here. Well, I'm gonna ignore him for now. We'll come back to him in a second.
I'll take a gin and tonic. Sorry, sir. This area is restricted for the private use of our hostess.
Oh, man. They got that guy right off the street. I mean, they were desperate in need for...
Pardon me, sir. Guests aren't allowed back here.
That's the same guy, only trying to make a slightly deeper voice. That's amazing. Let's talk to this guy anyway. There's no way to get to these people, at least from here, without starting a big firefight. We'll have to figure out a way around that later, but for now, let's talk to this guy. See what he's all about.
Ah, Mr. 47. The fates conspire to throw us together at last.
I appreciate your enthusiasm.
Don't be coy with me, 47. I know all about you. You're just the ungainly outcome of a childish experiment with genetic tinker toys. Super assassin, indeed. You're less than human, and I intend to prove it.
How do you intend to do that?
We're going to duel. Meet me in the room marked Torture Chamber.
All right, we're gonna meet with some stranger in the Torture Chamber. That sounds like fun. Yep. All right. So, we're gonna follow this guy.
He's quite a sight to look at, as it is.
It's basically wearing the priest outfit from Till Death Do Us Part, but it's red, and he has white gloves on and horns. Now, let's take a look. Wow.
This outfit is...
Oh my god! Oh, Jesus. Oh, wow. You guys are freaking me out. Goodbye. Damn, a lap dance or something. Why do you have your gun out? What? Oh, you know, I don't know. Something about this place is freaking me out. I think the torture chamber...
Here we stand. The world's best and second best assassins. Only the former will leave this room alive.
Right.
The soundproofing will prevent any interruptions.
Okay.
Your equipment is positioned by the couch.
Oh, thanks.
Arm yourself appropriately, my mutant adversary, and we'll commence.
If that's what you want.
And he runs away like a little bitch. So let's get our weapons. We got a Desert Eagle. That's a big boy gun. We got the MP7. I think this is the first time we've seen it. It's a hell of a gun. It really is. Ow! You fucking cheater. I haven't gotten started yet. Let's see if I can hit him. I don't think I hit him. Let's pick up this last bit of ammo. Like I was saying, the MP7... oh, shit. I'll talk about it in a second. So, this part here can be a bitch in Silent Assassin, especially if you don't have body armor. Oh, he's screaming. He's screaming for his mama. Oh, but he's still alive. Wow. Of course, with our vest, things are a lot easier. And, this damn thing won't open. Why is that? There we go. Alright. My god, he took a lot of damage. I think that guy had his own bulletproof vest on. Let's get in here. Maybe it's just the way the outfit looks, but I'll make sure he's dead. Fuck you, man. Maybe it's just the way the outfit looks. I guess this is white gloves, but his arms look like long monkey arms, don't they? I guess it's just an optical illusion, but his arm really does look, Let's try to flip him over so we can look at his face. Okay. Let's try to flip him over again. And there we go. Let's take a look. Wow, he really went all out. White facial hair, black contact lenses, pretty creepy. Okay. Let's get out of here. And let's... What? Okay, let's head out. Yeah, so... You know, that guy's taken care of, but, We gotta take care of two more targets, and as far as I can tell, there's no way to get in there without disturbing everyone. Now,
I actually forgot to get
my silver baller, so I can't snipe this lady from here, can I? not without raising a big stink. So, I think what I'm going to do is... Okay, right. Yeah, it's been a while since I recorded this video. So, I'm going to sneak back... Oh, shit. Ow! Really? You're going to shoot me for picking a lock? Come on, man. Good lord. I'll show you. Oh, fuck you. That's what you get. Bastard. Oh, look the way he's hanging. Oh, man. Fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you and fuck all of you. Damn. That's a lot of bodies. Oh. Reload here. Wow. I wasn't very accurate today, was I? What? Where'd he come from? There we go. What's going on? What do you mean, what's going on? Ow. What the... Fuck you, man. Ow, shit. Put that gun down. That's a big boy gun. You don't deserve a big boy gun. Oh, ow. Right behind the ear, and he's still walking around. What? I'm gonna change outfits, because... Well, they probably discovered that one by now. Oh. Let's take another look at this guy. Hey, stop slacking on the job. Stop doing stretches or whatever you're doing. Oh, man. Well, let's get back down here. And now we are backstage. Now, even as a guard, we wouldn't be able to go into that room where those two were when he passed that lady the gun. But this lady is going to be behind doors soon. Let's take a quick look around. All right. There is a weird thing where you can use that crate of fish to sneak a gun up to heaven, but it's kind of convoluted and pointless, so fuck that. And, well, here's our lady target here. She's getting ready for another performance, and we are going to fuck her up. We're gonna make sure that she dies. Just gonna rig...
This? There we go. Ugh.
Let's watch the show, shall we? And she's using her dark, satanic powers to conjure up flames. She's raising up those flames. And, who knows? Maybe she'll mess up. Maybe those flames will... scorch her alive. Just a matter of time. There we go. Finally. Oh no. Right into the drink, where she'll be eaten by a shark. And, yeah, there's a hammerhead shark, I think.
Okay, let's get out of here. There's really only one
more target we need to take care of. Mr. CIA agent himself. Let's, sneak around here. And in here. And, oh, there he is, just standing there. Let's use our scope. And he's dead. That's it. That's all she wrote. Never got to see what was in that case, but I'm sure we'll get to see next time. And, alright, the only thing left to do is to escape now. Let's get out of here. Ugh, I'm sorry, it's just, I'm a bit out of practice, I think.
You got no business here, buddy. Don't make me rip your head off.
Yeah, wow, that's pretty fucking aggressive. But dressed as a staff, we still can't go into that room.
Oh, the music has started now, though. Or maybe it started before, I just didn't notice. Whatever. Let's get out of here. And, you know, it's not our scheduled break, but we're going to leave anyway because, you know, our novel that we've been writing, you know, it just got optioned for a movie and they gave us like 40 grand. So we're going to go and, you know, I don't know, spend it on blow or something. Whatever waiters do when they sort of make it in Hollywood, but we're not even in Hollywood, are we? What am I talking about? I'm just ranting. All right, so... Long level, huh? Ooh, where's the exit? I think it's a van? Yeah, there it is. There's our way out of here. There's our ticket out. There we go.
Hey, 47. Ow, hey! It's me! It's me! Stop! It's me! I'm cool! Come on! Ah!
What are you doing here?
Just relax, please! You're my only hope. There's no one else.
Your only hope for what?
They're gonna kill the president. Don't want him reelected. He'll legalize cloning, ruin their plans.
Who are they?
You know... them! Already got a cloning program. Want the technology to themselves.
They can have it. I don't play politics. Now give me one good reason why I shouldn't put a bullet in your head.
I've got millions. Got the diamonds back there. Red suitcases worth millions. All yours.
What's the job?
They want to hit the president in 3 days. In the White House. You get in there, protect him. Take the assassins out.
Show me the money.
Thank God. Here's some. You get the rest after. What do you say?
I'll contact you with instructions on how to get me the rest of the money up front, and how to get me the mission details.
But then how can I be sure that...
If you're on the level, I'll do the job. If you're not, you won't be needing the money.
I hope that jacket's warm, because it gets really cold out in the desert, from what I understand. Alright, so that was Dance with the Devil, and what a level, huh? Wonder what I'm going to do for the Silent Assassin and, ooh, the Undertaker, that's a sexy title. Still got good amount of cash there, and no witnesses to bump up our notoriety rating, so that's good. Let's take a look at the newspaper. Now, I'll be honest, the newspaper for A Dance of the Devil is pretty milquetoast, pretty vanilla, pretty boring, not really much to say. Okay, so, if you don't get yourself seen, and I'm sure we'll see that in the Silent Assassin run coming up next, there's a picture of the CIA agent who, I guess, used to be a police officer or something, I don't know. He's got a really silly voice, that I hope you'll be able to hear later. I'll put that at the end of another video, not this video, though. Well, not really much to look at. Huh. Yeah. Of course, if you want to read it, the video is high quality enough where you can pause it and read it. Ugly dogs have their day, of course. And, what's over here? Poodle explodes in microwave, killing two. Jesus. I wonder if they counted the poodle, you know? Do they count the poodle? I don't know. Crack down on raves. Huh. And, well, the only interesting thing here, though, really, is on the left here. It's, Ducks of War. One duck, one kill. One duck, one kill. That's something else, huh? Alright, so that was it for... Let's Play Hitman Blood Money. I'm Nick Meister. I'll see you next time.